Flinks.
I really like how Kaiser went for this double nil talisman build. Queen of Pain, not often a hero that's like, do I really need to worry about runes? But when you've got to deal with this burst.
3-3, going in here. We'll find the solo kill on the Skyrat. Grabs the quick point and Gush. Perhaps caught him to like a quick mech for the team. In all likelihood.
Maybe they're just like gearing up towards a flat.
That's Venom. Could be. 3-3's there with the Ravage. Good early rotation by Swift Ending. And Pablo has to TP out, but they've got the vision through the trees with that Kraken. Or sorry, the Anchor Smash again. Another takedown by 3-3. Tiny and then get a Midas. It's like, shit, we have to do something.
Exactly. And it's not like it's not so dire that there's, I mean, he's got it completed at 13 minutes, plus a blink and a lot of
some fun. Caught out, glimpsed on back. He does get off the time dilation, but not escaping that one while Swift ending momentum and find a fight. That does to be seen. And gonna look for the opening now. That Tidehunter thought he was immortal. Is he though? Broken. Gets the pipe off. The timely bash is there, chuck him up, knock him down, he drops fast, and they do get
our hero with just one item and one spell is now Swift Ending, wanting to go on Handscuff.
Here, IO.
3,
got him. Half his health down, and now the Fissure, they're looking for Era as well. The Echo Slam comes through, Enchant Totem times it just right. And that's the feeling that Planet Dog have been searching for. A clean takedown. A lot of confidence to walk into this Roche Pit. Also knew Chronosphere was down until recently.
Planet Dog really half commit on it. Their alliance hasn't been playing as 5, and if you're Planet Dog, you're not going to be like, okay, I can Echo Slam 2 or 3 heroes, I can Static Storm 2 or 3 heroes, Ravage 2 or 3 heroes. You have to spend all of your ultimates in conjunction with each other.
But what are with these first hit bashes by Yonasumfan? Are you kidding me? He's going to get glimpsed back, though, and into the Cage of Doom. Static Storm's there, Klix is there, Faceless Void's corpse is also there as they quickly take him down. That was a very ambitious go on mid.
Yeah, and they only had to use one ultimate for that. That's what I'm saying, that you are Planet Dog, anytime you can only just spend one or two ultimates to get a kill, that's exactly the kinds of openings that allow you to start snowballing as now Era on the run, Handskin.
They got the vision on Handskin. It's gonna be like two shots from the Klix. They'll be able to bring him down here. The Glimmer Cape, and I'm sorry, that's an Invis rune actually. Not enough as they do pop the dust. Crack that eye open.
For a second I was mobile now. We said initially, like, other heroes, the non-core heroes, are kind of cumbersome, and now Disruptor.
Oh, he missed the last hit! Sad times for the Disruptor. You become about 30 gold short of that next component.
Though for what it's worth, he is very close to the Zagnus Center. Is that Milan going in?
Is it feed time?
Looks like it.
Apparently feed o'clock. Planet Dog will just give up a couple freebies.
Yonah's the big fan. Club. Spots the Chrono top. Relocate, gank.
What, the Queen of Pain has the cheese, has the BKB, he does pop it. Now he looks to turn. He thought about going for the IO and committing for Handskin, but Handskin, a bit pretty cheap, cost-effective, you know, mid-game style items, but hold that thought as Alliance are looking to make their move. Fissure was committed, and they're gonna jump. They want Kaiser, they find him too. Mystic Flare's there, layered over the top. Swift Ending just gets a few auto-attacks off on Yonasumfan, but the Fissure actually hurts him. It's Milan, he absolutely airballs the Echo. Now he's gonna pay. Yonasumfan there with the BKB. One more swing of that club will bring him down. Alliance just being fed these kills, and Handskin staying alive with the Glimmer Cape. He will make it back to safety, at least for now. Swift Ending got
dunked.
Timely dashes, and they get in. The dunk's there. A quick silence, though, prevents the fall. Milan's gonna back away, but the Static Storm, decently timed. Yonasumfan managed to get off the BKB, but he goes onto the Klinx. That's a tanky hero to focus down. He doesn't have the damage. He's got to back away. And meanwhile, to the north, Queen of Pain engages. We'll bring down Pablo, but in your face, Tiny is there with the club, takes the Rex down. Alliance say thank you very much.
But that's still pretty solid for Alliance.
And they're going to give up more if this Queen of Pain gets caught timely on the Yule. Good catch there. They want to bring the IO down. But Handskin with the Glimmer Cape. And they're going to chuck Swift Ending up in the air. Bring him back down to Earth. When the BKB wears off, there might be an opening, though. There's no IO supporting Era. Right around the Rosie. Pocket full of posies. Dead Tiny. Likely to be the result. The raid boss has been conquered. They'll take him down. But the trade, of course, is this Queen of Pain, who gets slowed down by Yonasumfan and eventually killed off. Somehow Handskin lived with that dog, but trying to find Handskin, but there's the buyback. Lib's gonna get back into this, clicking towards the pit and dropping the ward. Now he engages, but into the Ravage he goes. Echo Smash there, that frees up the Tiny, who can re-engage, not having to worry about that big AoE. The Roche is low, it's not dead yet. Still the Roche stands, the Bash is coming out all over the place, and Milan will snipe the Aegis. He force staffs his way over the Chasm, but now no Ravage, and only your support Shaker wielding that Aegis. He'll die once, he'll likely die twice. They chase for more, they fight 3-3. They're gonna bring him down too. The Tidehunter gets clubbed, and Alliance take not only a Rex, but a lot of kills to their name.
Inside that Roche pit, and they went in. And as a result, Era did have to buy back, but the Isle surviving was so important because he was managing to, like, he wouldn't have been able to buy back. And he's still alive, he's overcharging this Tiny, he's just chewing through these Raxes.
Never count out the Era Tiny, I suppose. That is the call for Alliance, especially if they get their hands on the Hanskin Io. Might not be the strongest combo in this meta, at least, you know, it's not a go-to duo, but Alliance finding a way to make it work here, and so now Planet Dog under the gun. They did push in the top lane, they got the tier 3, but they need more than that. The Static Storm's the point, the Fissure's perfect, on point on the defense, at least for now, but the base is in shambles as this melee's about to drop. BKB from Era, re-engage as well. Now, going to work on the reins. All of a sudden, it's gonna be full megas for Alliance. They might lose heroes, but the base is theirs, and likely the match as well. It's gonna be a very difficult uphill climb. Planet Dog want to somehow get back in this game. They are not the best team against Mega Creeps. Clix is awful. Tidehunter's middling. Queen of Pain's not that great with fours.
I don't really know what the dog can do.
Let's see what kind of decisiveness they have in store. They did get that tier 3 earlier, and that is the call onto the tier 4s. Alliance up Mega Creeps, but not having secured the game fully just yet. The tier 4 number 1 is down, looking for the second. The Ravage comes through, the Static Storm laid on top, a beautiful combination as Planet Dog sees momentum. They'll take down 2. Io buys back. Unfortunately, so too does the Void. They may have overplayed their hand here. Now the Chrono, the counterplay, locking down Kaiser. Creeps are pushing in top, and heroes are dying in the Alliance base, and not to the liking of Planet Dog. They almost lose Swift Denny. Hurricane buying back, tries to make it out. Not gonna happen. He gets decapitated, and now onto 33, who likely will drop here as well. Double buyback, but they don't have the Tidehunter round 2. They don't have the big combo for that last fight. They thought about tier 4s, then they went back for heroes. Alliance had the buyback.
One tier 4 remaining against Mega Creeps, against a Tiny with an AC and an Aghanim Scepter and a full Daedalus completed. I don't really know what you can do with no Tidehunter.
Jonas and Bang is there with the first hit bashes. We'll get the spot. Meanwhile, Echo Slam committed. They found the Tiny. The Fissure's on point. Can they burst him down? They will. He's out for 90, but the drone is in jeopardy now as the creeps start to work on it. They have to win these hero kills, and then they also have to defend their base. Swift Denny trying to bring down Jonas and Fan. He can't quite do it. Kaiser gets locked in position. He'll be brought down, and the creeps are swarming, zerging their way in the Planet Dog's homeland, and they've overrun the dogs. Alliance will seize the game, and with it, to a 1-0 start here in the group stage.